The Core Web Vitals offer a useful way to identify challenges users might face while they are on your pages. But how can you debug issues with these metrics? Well, it turns out you can very well start in your browser. It's important to remember that these metrics are taken from real user metrics, so people using your website in the real world. However, when debugging this, we can get a rough idea of what might cause problems by looking at lab data. This is data we can create and measure using our own devices. To start your debugging, it makes sense to get a first impression of the status quo using Lighthouse in our Chrome Developer Tools. We open the Developer Tools in our browser and navigate to the Lighthouse tab. There we can get an audit like this. Note that the responsiveness metrics, FID or INP, are field metrics and can't really be captured by Lighthouse. Instead, we'll use total blocking time as an approximate indicator. Lighthouse usually shows a set of recommendations that can help improve the performance quite a bit already. However, Lighthouse focuses on the performance of the initial page load. Let's take a look at a website here. According to Lighthouse, this website is doing very well in terms of performance. But as I click on this button, we can see that the browser stops responding to my clicks. Oh no, I don't want that many pizzas. That's frustrating. But because Lighthouse focuses on the initial load of the page, which is admittedly fast, it doesn't capture these issues. So debugging layout shifts or responsiveness problems are very hard to spot this way. Time to bring out the bigger tools, like the performance panel. This is what the performance panel will show you when you load a page and record the performance audit. This might look a bit scary at first, but, you know, let's break it down. On the top, we have an overview of all activity in the browser tab, including some screenshots, a waterfall of all the network requests and when they happened, the Web Vitals timeline if you enable it, and additional detail info on what is going on behind the scenes. With this panel, you can dig deeper into how the network requests, JavaScript code execution, and the Core Web Vitals work together. There are also the performance insights, which present this information in a more digestible timeline form. The big difference to Lighthouse is that you can record the performance during interactions with the page, and thus uncover responsiveness issues or layout shifts easier. So, in this video, we looked at the Devtools for debugging issues with Core Web Vitals. And while field data is still important to measure real users' experience on your sites, we do have a bunch of tools available to identify issues just using lab data. The big upside there is that we can do that during development and as an ongoing process to identify issues as they come up, rather than deploying something that is broken and then looking for remedial. I hope this was useful for some of you, and if you're interested in what other powers DevTools could give you, let us know in the comments below, and we might make another video about the others as well. Stay safe, have fun, and bye-bye!